Hello, today we will discuss about shock. So what is shock? Shock is characterized by systemic hypotension, either due to reduced cardiac output or due to reduced effective circulating blood volume. The consequences will be there will be decreased or impaired tissue perfusion and cellular hypoxia. So the shock can be reversible in the earlier stages. However, it can be irreversible in the later stages. So, causes and types of shock: cardiogenic shock, hypovolemic shock, septic shock, neurogenic shock, and anaphylactic shock. These are the five types of shock. So, the cardiogenic shock, as the name suggests, cardio means heart. It results from myocardial pump failure and which will result in low cardiac output. Hypovolemic shock is due to decrease in the plasma or the blood volume. And septic shock is a part of systemic immune reaction to the infection. Other types are neurogenic and anaphylactic shock. Now the cause of shock in bit detail. So cardiogenic shock. Cardiogenic shock we earlier studied. The reason was the heart problem. It can be myocardial infarction, ventricular rupture, arrhythmia, cardiac tamponade, pulmonary embolism. Mechanism behind this is either the myocardial pump is failed in this case, or secondly, it can be due to obstruction of the outflow of the blood. Hypovolemic shock is due to fluid loss, which can be due to hemorrhage, vomiting, diarrhea, burns, trauma. In this, what will happen is there is reduced blood or plasma volume. Then is septic shock. Septic shock is due to infections, superantigens. In this, these antigens will lead to endothelial activation, leukocyte activation, complement system activation. This we will discuss in detail. Then there is neurogenic shock, which is due to anesthetic accident or spinal cord injury. And anaphylactic shock is due to IgE-mediated hypersensitivity. Now, studying about the pathogenesis, basic pathogenesis of all form of shock is there is reduced effective circulating blood volume. So, blood volume can be normal, but the tissues which are supplied are not getting that supply. That is, there is effective blood volume is reduced. There can be reduced supply of oxygen to the tissue with resultant anoxia. There can be inflammatory mediators will be released because of the cellular injury. Now going to the septic shock. Septic shock is a question asked in MBBS examinations. Now it is most frequently triggered by gram-positive bacterial infection followed by gram-negative and fungi. That is, most common cause is gram-positive organisms and not gram-negative organisms. Earlier, the name septic shock was synonymous with endotoxic shock, which is nowadays not synonymous according to the recent Robbins. Now going to the pathophysiology of the shock, of septic shock. Now what happens is, in a body, any microbe enters, they release endotoxin, or there are various microbial products which are released. This will lead to neutrophil or monocyte activation, and due to these inflammatory cell activation, there is release of the cytokines like TNF or interleukin-1. And these TNF and interleukin-1, they are responsible for the systemic effects seen in the shock, which are fever, any metabolic abnormalities like lactic acidosis. Then also these cytokines are also responsible for the endothelial activation. This endothelial activation will take place, will result in liberation of various interleukins, nitric oxide, reactive oxygen species. This will lead to vasodilation. As nitric oxide is released, there will be decreased perfusion, and because of reactive oxygen species, there will be injury to the endothelium and there will be increased permeability. This all leads to multi-organ failure. Also, there is activation of the complement system. It also activates the endothelium. There is also activation of the factor 12, which is also known as Hageman factor, and it increases the coagulation cascade. There is procoagulation. It is procoagulant in nature and antifibrinolytic, which will lead to thrombi formation. Now, the thrombi formation is so much that it leads to a condition known as DIC. What is DIC? It is disseminated intravascular coagulation. In this, what happens is there is thrombi formation in the blood vessels. It is so widespread that it consumes the platelets, and there it leads to bleeding diathesis. There is formation of thrombi so much that at last there is no platelet for the normal body to process. And because there is thrombosis, it will also lead to tissue ischemia and lead to multi-organ failure. So, at the end, we can summarize the pathophysiology of septic shock by noting that the various cells like macrophages, neutrophils, endothelial cell, they recognize and are activated by several substances derived from the microorganisms. And these factors which are liberated, they interact in such a complex fashion to produce a condition known as septic shock, and which will further lead to multi-organ dysfunction. Now going to a term known as superantigens. What are superantigens? They are a class of antigens which will cause polyclonal T lymphocyte activation. Now before understanding what are superantigens, we should know what are antigens. Antigens, they activate only a one clone of T lymphocyte, but superantigen, they activate polyclonal T lymphocytes. So with normal antigen, there is release of cytokines, which is normal in amount. This is not so high in level, but with superantigen, they release high levels of cytokines, and there is the clinical symptoms which are produced are in increased severity. So stages of shock. First is the early non-progressive stage. In this, the neurohumoral mechanism, they may help to maintain the cardiac output and the blood pressure. Example, baroreceptor reflexes, catecholamine release, the RAS system, the ADH release. These all will lead to tachycardia, peripheral vasoconstriction, and renal conservation of the fluid. Now, the patient goes in the second stage, if not treated, that is progressive decompensated shock. In this, there is tissue hypoperfusion and there is worsening of the circulatory and metabolic imbalances. Then third is the irreversible stage. This takes place if no recovery is there. In this, what happens is there is progressive vasodilation, there is increased vascular permeability, there is pulmonary hypoperfusion, and there is anoxic damage to the heart, kidneys, and brain. Now going to the morphology of various organs, we will discuss in this in here. What happens is morphology, it is mostly seen in the brain, heart, lungs, kidney, adrenals, and GIT. It is mainly the hypoxic injury, like in kidneys, it leads to acute tubular necrosis. The cell death occurs, there is necrosis of the tubules. In adrenals, what happens is there is cortical lipid cell depletion. This is due to, because in shock, there is catecholamine release, and catecholamine release occurs from the adrenal cells. So, normally the cells of adrenal are inactive and they are vacuolated. But in case of shock, they become metabolically active and they utilize all the stored lipids for the synthesis of steroids. Lungs, they are very less affected in case of shock, but if affected, there will be diffuse alveolar damage. Thank you. Please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.